You know, when they told us that when Hitler came to Vienna, you had to, with toothbrushes, wash the sidewalk. Who would believe such a thing? That was before they discovered that the concentration camps. The whole world didn't believe. Europe didn't believe. The Allies didn't believe. So how should we believe?
When she was 15 years old, Clara Kramer and her family survived Nazi occupation of her town by hiding for almost 2 years. She documented that time in a diary that became the book Clara's War. Hi, I'm Rebecca Brayton, and welcome to WatchMojo.com. Today we're speaking with Clara Kramer about her life in Poland before the war and why she felt the need to keep her diary.
Let's start off by having you tell us about your hometown.
In a small city, it was a happy childhood. Everybody knew me. On my way to school, which was like 10 minutes, I could meet six people that I knew. My aunts, my uncles, and my mother's friend that I called my aunt. Then I lived in a two-family home with my grandparents. You get a lot of love. Today they tell you need a lot of love. I grew up with a lot of love. Then when the war broke out and the Russians came, we were persecuted because we were rich. My grandfather perished in a Russian jail. My grandmother and one of my mother's brothers and sister with their families were taken, put into cattle cars. For months we didn't know where they are, and then they found themselves in Asia. To me, the city was one big cemetery. Wherever I passed by homes where my friends lived, my family lived, I cried. So when came time to leave, I was glad to leave there. And the only reason I went there 3 times is to show the people the bunker. The minute we came to the bunker, and you have to imagine, the bunker was a crawl space. I don't know if you ever saw the crawl space. It is underneath the house, brick columns holding up the floor. We dug there. It is dripping from the walls. I had long braids that I had to cut for hygiene. I'm scared, I'm hungry, I'm thirsty. My mother, all of a sudden, she wants me to write a diary. I couldn't even understand her. So of course, I said to her, Ma, what for? They will kill us anyway. So she quietly said, they will find it and know what happened to you. Once I started writing, I wrote every single day, even when there was nothing to write about.
Why? Originally, did you keep the diary?
20-some-odd years ago, I had a pacemaker installed. And I said to myself, I'm not going to live forever. I have this diary. It's in Polish. Not even my grandchildren can read it. So I sat down, my own English. I translated it for my grandchildren initially and gave the original to the museum in Washington. Also, debating with myself, the majority of the survivors went to Israel. Israel has a lot of witnesses, but in America you have already deniers. And again, I don't say I'm very proud of the book and there is going to be a movie. To me, I'm still teaching Holocaust.